Just want to go over this partnership that Daryl mentioned, and thank you for the opportunity to come here and you know, let you know what we're doing to try to improve our canopy around the city. Where's the, here, thank you. So this donation came in from the Hampton Roads Community Foundation, and the whole idea here is to, you know, really get on board with trying to increase our canopy. The goal that was set by the city of Norfolk is 40%, okay? But that really doesn't mean a whole lot unless we know where we are today. So where we are today is 33%, okay? This was a study that was done, and, you know, how many trees do we need to make up that 7% canopy? Well, I did some figures, and based on approximately a 32-foot canopy spread for an average-sized tree for this area, and that's, you know, looking at the species around the area that, you know, small species, large species, and bringing that all together, and you get about a 32-foot average canopy spread. And that means we actually need to plant approximately 113,000 trees to make up that 7%. So how do we do this? Well, we need initiatives like street tree planting, which is what we're going to be discussing tonight, living legacy groves, which thank you, Mayor, for your initiative and really pushing that forward. And we just did the one at Community Beach Park, so thank you for being there. Arbor Day tree seedling giveaways, where we work with the master gardeners and growing these seedlings and adopting those out to citizens to try to get them more involved and really build that partnership. Because without the community's involvement, you know, it's going to be very difficult to get there. And then obviously, like we're going to discuss tonight, these private tree donations. So we're here to actually request this donation. It's $20,000 from the Hampton Roads Community Foundation. The whole understanding that they have is that if we plant trees, people will come. They'll come because we have more beauty in the city. Trees are pretty things, and people want to see them, and it brings other things along with that. We all know that trees, you know, produce oxygen, but other things that trees provide are going to be clean air, clean water, stormwater control, which is really important in our area. And also what people don't always think about and remember is that when it brings people to the community because of the beauty of the trees, it improves commerce. And that's something everybody can agree is really important. So out of all these trees that are coming in, it's approximately 55 trees. We have swamp white oaks, white fringe tree, and crepe myrtle. And there's going to be 46 swamp white oaks, approximately 6 white fringe trees, and I believe it's 3 Natchez crepe myrtles. And the swamp white oaks and all of this together, you'll see going down the corridor there, is really going to enhance the beauty and actually tie into a lot of the canopy that's already there. So what we didn't want to do is do something that was going to be so drastic of a change that it might look odd. All of this will tie in together, and the species that we have here can actually be okay with some periodic flooding, which could possibly happen in along those areas. So we wanted to make sure that what we put in is going to last. Okay, so matching funds are not required for this project. This is strictly all part of that donation. Everything will be taken care of through those funds, and the tree canopy coverage will be increased by approximately 3 acres along that corridor. So within that stretch is actually going to be increased quite a bit. So the planting will be completely performed by a contractor. So Parks and Urban Forestry, Recreation Parks and Open Space will move forward with getting the contract together and following on with that contract to make sure everything is installed and done properly. So when we went, we thought, okay, well, we want to make sure that we're getting the Tree Commission on board. We presented to the Tree Commission. Tree Commission says more trees, improving the environment, improving our area, bringing more commerce. Absolutely. What's not to like about this project? We went to Public Works and said, you know, is there any issue? Do you see any issue with where we're going to put these trees to see if there's any clear vision issues? Are there any reasons not to put anything, any conflicts? Absolutely not. Go for it. We like it. Wonderful. So we thought, okay, let's make this happen. We want to get this done by the end of planting season this year, so all the trees will be good to go.
Planting season is when?
So you can start planting trees basically coming into October, but we want to finish by February. You can plant into March. But for us, we want to make sure that we finish, you know, into February. So that way we can make sure that when the trees go in, we don't have frozen soils here. You'll still get root development throughout the winter. And then when that spring, you know, growth flush hits, trees are going to be in the ground ready to rock and roll. They'll be good to go. And this is just kind of I just want to give a visual representation of kind of the south end of where this is going to be and looking kind of north. And you'll see how these trees are going to come in. And from north looking south. And you'll see how these trees are going to look along that corridor there. As you drive down there and these trees get big, these trees can get 60 to 70 feet tall and actually have about a 60-foot canopy spread. So as these trees get big, you'll have that nice corridor look along there that you can drive by and really appreciate, you know, hey, you're coming into the city of Norfolk. Here's what you see and appreciate the project.
What size tree are you putting?
We're looking at a 2-inch caliper.
If it's coming under that, what are you going to do? You add more corridors?
This is Hampton Boulevard?
But it's north of...
I'm sorry. North of the yacht club.
That's the yacht club right there.
So it's going to go from the yacht club all the way down to essentially the naval base. So we're talking that whole line of...
So it'll go north of Little Creek?
Bowling to Terminal. So it'll go all the way up to north
Bowling
of Terminal.
Bowling also?
Uh-huh. From Bowling all the way to Terminal, essentially.
Oh.
So we'll be on both sides of the bridge.
Other side of the bridge, too.
Absolutely. So this is pretty substantial.
Do trees slow trucks and cars down?
That's a great question, and thank you for asking that. I love that question because
pine cones and
for every single you know thing that is somebody might consider maybe an ill of a city, you can say, well, the trees actually will cure that. So if you have traffic issues, plant trees. It'll slow the traffic down. People tend to kind of look around and notice more. You'll get a calming effect too with the trees there. So that actually has another effect on traffic. Slows it down. People see the beauty, especially when you start to see some fall color in there, and people will kind of slow down to look at that.
But if your bids come in under, are you going to add trees somewhere else? Because, I mean, that's almost $400 a tree.
Right. So part of what we're looking at here is the trees will have a two-year warranty, so that will be built in too. So what we don't want to do is we don't want to get into a situation where if we get into a drought, that the trees are only on a one-year warranty and, you know, we don't actually meet that. They have a problem after that first-year warranty is up. So we have that two-year warranty. So that'll take up some of that cost. If we do have some extra funds and we will look around, we do have some other options that we can look at as well.
You're going to have funds. It's a tough one. Tree that lives 1 year, 95% of them are fine after that. That's just my personal opinion. Those trees shouldn't cost over a couple $100 planted each.
That's your professional.
Right. It's 44 years, so it hasn't been doing that.
These have all been planted in the verge in the middle.
One, Daryl, great job hiring him. So since he's come on board, I've noticed a lot of changes and being more proactive. Well, good job for hiring. Anyway.
I didn't do that.
But I just have a quick, can we put something, do we have a link that citizens can recommend trees placement?
Yes, sir.
We do,
absolutely.
Okay. I don't know
if we have one, but we need to define it some more and we'll work on that.
All right, because I get requests all the time for people and I'd like to send them to that link. And the other thing is, I know Dominion Power, we accepted money from them to replace the trees that they took down. Is that money set aside somewhere to replace those trees?
Yes.
Or is it? Are we not using it to offset anything, are we?
No, sir. Okay. Especially earmarked for tree replacement for Dominion Power projects.
Okay. But not necessarily in that area because they don't want us to put trees back that they took down.
I'm curious about this, where you had about the tree donation project. I think it's a really exciting idea. I mean, to really kind of get people involved. Like, I'm interested that this gentleman decided that that was what he, how he wanted to contribute. Are we, what are we doing to market that idea? I mean, I think a lot of people would be excited about the idea of planting a tree in honor of somebody or to memorialize, and they may not know how to do that.
Absolutely, and what we're looking at doing, or one of my goals here, is to make sure that, you know, really working with Daryl and talking about some of the things that, you know, that we did, you know, that I've done in the past, and really trying to bring that here is, you know, really trying to get a central focus on, you know, celebrate trees, make that our goal, and then say, okay, if you have a question, go here. This is where we need you to go. We're working on our website, like Daryl said, and make sure that if anybody says anything, wants trees, has questions about it, go to that central point of contact. If we have that central point of contact, then we'll be able to answer those, follow up, and then steer people where to go to try to keep this going.
But I'm even thinking of giving people the idea of doing it.
Sure.
You know, instead Absolutely. Of them having to look for a site to be able to do it.
And so that, and that's part of what we hope to do with this. It was an anonymous donation made through the Community Foundation, and so the idea is that maybe there'll be momentum if we do this really right and prove to the public that we can commit to something and follow through and see kind of the fruit of it, if you will, that other people will follow upon.
Well, I mean, we've done that. And, I mean, just the tree we planted the other day at Ocean View, the Kiwanis Club down there. I mean, we had three of them. The Lions Club were supportive. The first ones we built over it, the first ones we planted in Lakewood had sponsors. I mean, we have...
I just mean, you know, I think it'd be great to get the average folk out there to know. I mean, we've done well thus far, but we can always do better. So
I'd like to see a program where you could buy a tree for your birthday and plant it and give it to the city. You know, I mean, or somebody could buy a tree for somebody's birthday. You'd be surprised how many. Our sister city in Japan does that, and they plant thousands of trees.
So do you have to have the number of rings around the tree?
Yeah.
Mine would be a really big tree.
This is really, Michael, welcome on board. And I think, you're doing all the right things for sure. I'm glad to see you're purchasing some crepe myrtles. Somebody came in here once and said, was it you, Daryl? We don't like crepe myrtles. I said, wait a minute, who made that decision? I mean, this is weed stuff. I mean, color makes a lot of difference, too.
But there's some science behind that, too, that if there were a blight in crepe myrtles and you had a preponderance of those, then your city canopy is preponderantly
right,
lost.
Right, we're looking at right tree in the right location.
Right.
And
balance means everything, but they didn't like maintaining the crepe myrtles. There was nothing wrong with the crepe myrtles. They didn't like them in the medians. And it was just some people didn't like
Fred Hewitt would be proud of you.
I know, my father did it with Fred.
I got two.